This week on Fly Rod Chronicles, we're in my home state of West Virginia. You know, this week, we're gonna catch a lot of fish, but it is gonna be like a history lesson. You know, we're going to Southern West Virginia, and we're gonna be talking a little bit about the Hatfields and McCoys, but we're also gonna be talking about the Coal Wars, and we're gonna talk about the stream restorations. We're gonna be talking about the great efforts that the West Virginia Division of Natural Resources have been taking to bring this river back.
Traveling the world, fishing, enjoying the great outdoors. Those are things that would have seemed impossible to me when I was a kid growing up in the mountains of West Virginia. I'm a lucky man, and I never want to forget it, and I'm hoping that sharing my experiences with folks will inspire them to do the same. I'm Curtis Fleming, and these are my Fly Rod Chronicles.
I was mesmerized by your eyes. Keep me up every night. Keep me up every night. There ain't no satisfaction for me now. There ain't no satisfaction for me now. There ain't no satisfaction for me now.
So, on this shoot, you know, we had a lot of homework to do. The only thing going into this, I just knew that we were going to cover the Tug River. And I knew that there was a lot of history, a lot of history with the Hatfield and the McCoys, a lot of history that was kind of dear to my heart with being a son of a coal miner and having a lot of that heritage in my background. I knew about the Matewan massacre. I knew about the Cold Wars that took place down there. So I was excited about going into this area and learning about that. We heard that the Tug River is one of those places that's like coming back. You know, they're cleaning up the river. There's a lot of efforts of people cleaning up the Tug River. So that's always exciting for us to get involved in projects like that. So, you know, working with the West Virginia Division of Natural Resources and relying on them to learn more about the fisheries and in this river, this was something that was really exciting for us.
Boy.
Oh,
and he spit it. Woo!
Nice.
I like it. Put her in. Let's keep going. Thank you, buddy. Thank you.
Nice fish on.
Back on the concern.
Nice one. That's a pretty fish.
Very nice. Beautiful.
Nice, sir. Oh, there he is. There he is.
That's a good one. Good one. Good one. Fish. Nice, attaboy. Pretty good, Charlie. So Tim, you're back home, man. You're back where you grew up, and tell me about what it feels like.
It feels good. It's been about 5 years since I've been back to my hometown where I grew up and went to high school and got a scholarship to Marshall University running track and cross country.
It's got to feel good. And behind us, I mean, this fires me up because, you know, I come from, my father was a coal miner. His father was a coal miner. His father was a coal miner. On my mom's side, you know, several generations was coal miners. Tell me, what is this behind us?
It's very interesting, Curtis. This is actually one of the first of two that I know of ever built of a house of coal. It was built around 1933, and it's to honor the coal heritage here in the Tug Valley region, and they constructed this out of coal and turned it into the Chamber of Commerce. It's been a center to draw people here to come and see the center of West Virginia and Williamson as well. Yeah.
Falls and we all pray, hoping for the light of day down to the river. I have held the devil's hand, felt the weight of my own sin, burdened by the heart of man, down to the river, down to the river.
There we go. Oh, that's a good one. Good fish. Oh, good fish. We'll bring Charlie. Whoa! That a boy.
Woo!
Nice.
Mama taught me how to live. Daddy taught me how to give. Both of them had their own sins, down to the river, down to the river. Sing, oh, oh, bury me, carry me, oh, oh, far beneath, oh, oh, fire and water me, going down deep, singing, oh, oh, bury me, carry me, oh, oh, far beneath, oh, oh, fire and water me, watching me.
Hey, Jim, I've been gone quite a few years, and could you let me know, just inform me about what's been going on with the river? I noticed there's less garbage. I see that the tires are getting sparser. So could you elaborate on the efforts you guys,
sure,
and who was involved?
Sure, be happy to. And we really want to tip our hat to Christy Bailey with the Coal Heritage Foundation out of Beckley. They're a nonprofit that helps underserved coal communities. One of the things that we identified was that, you know, if you're going to be a tourism-driven destination, you need to have everything ready for your guests when they come. And we needed to clean some things up. I think last count, we probably took close to 10,000 tires out of the river over the last 5 years.
The efforts are shown. You can tell a difference. You can tell the water quality and the fish, different species of fish that are true indicators. I'm no biologist, but we had one with us today, and he said we have a great river. It's a beautiful river.
Diverse.
We lack a little bit of access,
yes,
which is something that we hopefully take from here and show the right people what we need here in Southern West Virginia to just take us to the next level.
Welcome back to Fly Rod Chronicles. We're going to take a short break from fishing. You know, this is like a history lesson. You know, every time I go fishing, I learn something about the area that I'm fishing. You know, everyone seems to know about the Hatfields and McCoys. I mean, very tough times. And you know what Sid Hatfield, you know, what he went through in the early 1900s and the whole massacre, you know, we get to meet a local who's teaching us more than we could get from any history books.
Built in 1908, and as you can see, J.B. Maynard was the chief of police back then. It was built by N&W Railroad. They were N&W back then, and the railroad built this for the town as the jail. The historic part of it is this was Sid Hatfield's jail. This is where he worked, and then of course Mayor Testerman, who got killed in the May 1 massacre, worked in City Hall. This was the lockup and City Hall, both. And this is where Sid would report to work. And with undoubtedly that day he was here and got up and went over across the tracks. There was no road here then.
Right.
Went across the tracks and ended up being in the deadliest gunfight in American history, was with the Battle of Mate One or Mate One Massacre.
Wow.
Spit the fly there. Hey, that's the fly you were talking about, huh?
Yeah, yes, sir. We put her back on, didn't we?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Thank you, buddy. Tug, tug, fork, bass. I like it. Care if I put it back?
Yes, sir. You do your thing.
Man, needed that one.
That's a pretty fish.
Needed that one, huh?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, brother.
Tell you a little something about me. When it's Saturday night, I need to blow off some steam. One, two, three, four! Well, I've been holding in since the clock came Monday morning.
Hey!
From the end of the week, I'm about to blow. Rain walking through the honky-tonk like a pack of wolves now. Water up around the traps, and it's away we go. Fix up, go down, get down, order up another.
My first tug fork, huh? Nice.
So, brand new water for us. We're used to being up in the upper part of the state here and get 2 days to come down here and check out the tug. It was pretty cool, pretty cool. It's a beautiful section of water that we got to run the last couple days. So, what do you guys think?
Yeah, no, it was awesome. And it definitely holds a lot of different species of fish. I mean, you know, we caught smallmouth, we caught gar, we saw muskie, we saw carp. It was a nice stretch of river for sure. It just needs, you know, it still needs a little TLC to get it to where it needs to be, but the potential is definitely there. Yeah.
Doc, what'd you feel? How'd you like the water?
I love the water. The water's real good. You know, it's a little murky, but you know, it murky water don't hurt nothing.
Yeah.
You know, there's still fish. There was a lot of fish in there. We seen some nice fish.
It's, I think, a very viable fishery to be able to do commercial trips on, for folks to be able to get out, and you have so many amenities here. I mean, we're staying at Chief Logan State Park, but there's plenty of little cabins for rental, and of course you got Hatfield McCoy Trail down here, and I mean, great place. I could see us coming down and spending another weekend or two down here, I think.
Now, this has been a great trip down here on the Tug Fork. It's not a watershed I know really well. We had some great local folks that came out, introduced us to the area. I've worked with John and some of the local groups. One of the reasons that I wanted to come down here, it's great to see a community kind of come together and embrace that watershed. They've been very dedicated into cleaning it up, getting that water out, starting to see some of the economic development coming from that. And there, it's really that community coming around, supporting that river and making it what it could be and sharing it with people. I think this will be a great first step to forwarding the progress on the tug.
This was such a fun show to make. You know, it's no secret, this region of our state has went through some really hard times. But what I didn't expect is how good these people treat you, how good the people are down in the southern part of West Virginia. I had no idea that the smallmouth bass was such a good fishery down here. That secret's out now. It's unbelievable. The good part of this is next week we're going to be fishing the tributaries of the tug, and we're going to change it up a little bit. We're going to use lighter rods, and we're going to be chasing trout. That's exciting. We're going to go over the mountain, and we're going to fish a couple other counties, and we're going to be chasing trout. So come back next week. And you got to check us out. I think you're going to like next week's show.